I guess. Who up here has been hypnotized? You indicated by me?
No.
No. And you indicated you. So you two have had some experience with it, right? Say, well, do you guys last year, you can see some people that haven't had experience with it. Not ever hypnotized? Not ever? No. Wouldn't be. How did I do that? Would you?
Yes.
Yes. Thank you. Your first name is?
Cheryl.
Cheryl, nice to meet you. And your name, sir?
John.
John, and you are?
Sam.
For Samantha, I'm just guessing. Okay, John, I didn't get a chance to go up and touch you on the shoulder and stuff. So do you think you're hypnotized right now?
No.
Wide awake, right?
Wide open.
Totally wide open. Here's what I did, clearly, looking for people that I would consider good hypnotic subjects. Let me try to do the as best I can to explain. In my parlance, a good visualizer is someone that can easily take an image, convert that image into action. Ask a good visualizer to visualize their fingertips as magnets, you get a very dramatic response. A good visualizer imagines 100 balloons filled with helium, often the arms will, what we call, levitate straight up in the air. What I would call a good visualizer. All these folks appear to be good visualizers. So observe what happens when you simply ask good visualizers to begin visualizing other things. Wide awake, but with these beautiful circular lights up there, almost kind of like Olympic rings, right?
Yes.
Would you pick one spot on one of those rings? What am I trying to do here? Focus down attention, right? Stop the attention wandering all over. Bam. Take a nice deep breath, would you? Beautiful sleep, deep sleep, just like a ragdoll. Loose and hold down. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Deeper and deeper. One more, relax. Eyes wide, count of 5, 1, 3, 5. Okay, wait. Oh, so do you think you're hypnotized at all?
No.
Take a deep breath, would you? Deep sleep, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Loose sleep, just like a ragdoll. Deeper and deeper. One more relaxed. Deeper and deeper, all the way down. Would you mind making sure he doesn't hit the floor? What we call a flopper in the business. All right, deeper and deeper, one more relaxed until I ask you to wake up. That was distracting. One more relaxed, deeper and deeper until I ask you to wake up. Now, Adam, your first name is Sam. Yes, I am. Would you pick a spot on any of those rings? Just trying to get you to focus on a spot. You got it? How about you? Are you hypnotized?
I don't think so.
Good news. Pick a spot, look at it. You got it? Take a nice deep breath, would you? Excellent. Deep sleep, boy. Just like that. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Take a deep breath.
Let's try again.
Take a deep breath. Ready? Deep. 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 One more. Now, 5, 4.
It's not
two.
Working.
Well, I'll come back. Fair enough. All right. Promise I do you last. Your first name.
Eliza.
Nice. Pretty name. Did you pick a spot? Just look at it, Eliza. Take a deep breath, would you? Beautiful. Sleep. Deep. Sleep. Just like a rat. Deep. More relaxed. Feet relax, let your legs relax, all the muscles in your stomach and back relax, loosen, all the way down, deeper and more relaxed, every single breath around, take it down, deeper and deeper, more and more relaxed, all the way down, deeper and deeper, more and more relaxed, loosen, we're going to do something just a little bit different, okay?
Alright.
Next spot, just keep looking at it, please don't take your eyes off until I ask you. Excellent. Now I know that you are all relaxed. I know that you're feeling something, feel tingling and sensation in their toes or in their fingertips. All that's perfectly natural. And as I say, I know you're relaxed. What I'm going to do is show you folks how you can become much, much, much more relaxed. I'm going to start counting in just a few minutes backwards from 5 down to 1. I want you to use those numbers. I want you to imagine that with each of those numbers I count, that you can actually feel yourself sinking and drifting down deeper into this relaxation. What we're going to attempt to do is relax every single muscle of your body, from the top of your head to the tips of your toes, so deep and so relaxed, that by the time I reach the number 1, I want you to imagine that every single muscle in your body, from the top of your head to the tips of your toes, totally, perfectly, wonderfully, deeply relaxed. I'm going to start that process, like we've been doing so far, with just a nice deep breath. Breathe in deeply. And as you exhale, slowly, 5. Start dropping down deeper. Let all those muscles in your feet and legs loosen and relax again. Let all the muscles in your feet, all the muscles in your legs, feel them going limp and loose, dropping down deeper and deeper and deeper and deeper and deeper. You're concentrating perfectly. Let's take another nice deep breath now. Breathe in deeply. And this time as you exhale all the way down, those muscles in your stomach and back unwind and loosen. Let all the tension in your shoulders simply drop out of your body. All the tension in your shoulders now simply drops away as you're drifting deeper now. Deeper down, deeper down, deeper down. You're concentrating perfectly. Take a nice deep breath, breathe in deeply. And this time as you exhale all the way down, let the muscles in your neck just totally, totally relax. Let that heavy head of yours drop, flop down wherever it wants to go. Let yourself drift down deeper and deeper and deeper and sleep all the way down. You're concentrating perfectly now. Deeper with every single breath that you take. Deeper and deeper, more and more relaxed. We're almost there now, just one more number to go. And when we reach this final number, I'm going to ask you to let every muscle in your body just go limp. All those muscles around your face and jaws, all the muscles in your head and scalp, all the muscles in your body just totally, completely loose and limp and relaxed. Let's take that final breath now, breathe in deeply. And sleep, way down deep, one. Deeper and deeper now, dropping deeper with every breath you take. Sleep deeper and deeper, more and more relaxed. Sleep way down deep. Deeper and deeper, drifting now, deeper and more relaxed with each and every breath you take. You're concentrating beautifully. From this moment forward, any sounds you hear are just going to relax you more. If someone were to drop a glass or make a noise, that's just going to relax you more. Any sounds from the group or the audience, just relax you more. Let's just let my voice do all the work. Just drift, sink it deeper, deeper, more and more relaxed until I ask you to awaken. You're doing great. I invited these folks to join me up front because they appear to be good visualizers. Ask a good visualizer to visualize their arms holding 100 balloons. The arms will levitate or rise into the air. Ask a good visualizer to visualize every muscle from the top of their head to the tips of their toes totally relaxed. Here's what you end up with, folks. A relaxation that is almost unreal. A person whose every single muscle totally limp and loose and relaxed. These folks, in fact, are pretty much as relaxed as human beings can be and still be drawing a breath. Now, a lot of people stop me at this point and they say, just teach me this much. You know, if you could show me how to do this, if you're telling me I can go home every afternoon and 5 minutes later just be this relaxed, well, you know, I'll bet my concentration will improve. I'll bet that, you know, I'll be able to get to sleep better at night. I'll bet that, you know, my tension headaches will disappear. My stomach problem might go away. Just teach me the relaxation part. And in fact, a lot of people do like to learn just this aspect of it. This just profound relaxation. Remember one of my three promises, you're gonna be very relaxed? It's because of this. But there's a lot more to this than just the relaxation. The reason they're experiencing this profound relaxation simply has to do with what I've been asking them to visualize. I've been asking them to visualize every muscle from the top of the head to the tips of loose, limp, relaxed, and that's the visualization. What do you suppose would happen if we changed the picture? In other words, what's the opposite of loose, limp, and relaxed? How about stiff and rigid? If I had them focus on a different image, would you expect to get a different response? That, in a nutshell, is what this presentation is all about. I'm saying if you're currently focused on making $100,000 a year, and you began to focus on making $200,000 a year, you'd probably see your production numbers go up. If you're currently focused on being an MDRT qualifier and started focusing on being top of the table, your production numbers would probably rise. If you say to yourself, I can deal with young professionals, but I can't really deal with or relate to these high net worth, high income multimillionaires, you're probably never going to have high income, high net worth multimillionaire clients until you can see yourself dealing with them. A lot of what you do it there is the way you see yourself, agreed? So let's change the picture and see what comes out of it. You're all drifting down deeper in a moment. I'm going to lift one of your arms. As I extend your arm, I want you to use your imagination, feel that arm becoming stiff and rigid like a steel bar. Feel that happen. As I extend that arm, feel that arm locking tightly into place. As I extend your arm, I feel that arm locking into place like a bar of steel. Stiff and rigid. Stiff and rigid. Concentrate. Stiff and rigid like a steel bar. As I lift your arm, feel that arm locking tightly into place. Stiff and rigid. Rigid and stiff. Just like a bar of steel that has been welded to your shoulder. Concentrate now, stiff and rigid. As I extend your arm, stiff like a bar, stiff, rigid, like a steel bar welded to your shoulder. More stiff, more rigid. In fact, in a moment, I'm going to begin slowly counting backwards again from 3 down to 1. With each number I count, you're going to feel that I'm getting even more stiff and even more rigid. So stiff and rigid that by the time I reach number 1, It's going to feel as rigid and stiff as if it were a bar of steel welded to your shoulders. So rigid and stiff, you'll discover you can't lower or bend it until you hear me clap my hands. Can't lower or bend it until I clap my hands. Three, feel that arm now, more stiff, more rigid. Two, like a bar of steel now that has been welded to your shoulder. Three, two, and one. So rigid, so stiff, even as you try to push the arm down now, it won't go. It's locked into place. It's a rigid, stiff bar of steel. Harder you try, the more stiff and rigid it gets. Even as I press on the arm, even as you feel me pressing, stiff and rigid, stiff and rigid. You're not trying hard enough. Stiff and rigid. The harder you try, the more stiff and rigid it becomes. Stiff and rigid. Rigid and stiff, like a bar of steel welded to your shoulder and just getting more stiff and rigid by the moment. Angus, you ever see this before?
No.
Step in my office. Help me out. We're going to do the guys first. Please don't wang down. I just need a steady downward pressure. Just a test of strength. Press on the arm before the loop that feels like in terms of degree of strength.
It's definitely opposing, yeah. Right?
Well, maybe this guy takes steroids, works out every day. Try this guy. What would you say? How would you read?
Same
thing. Yeah. Well, you know, maybe we got two guys that work out. Can't have three in a row here. Press down this guy's arm. Works out.
That's very strong.
Remember I said don't wang down on your arm. You know, we've always been taught that women have less upper body strength than men do, so you would reasonably expect that females should have less strength like that. Would you press down that young lady's arm before they look that feels like in terms of degree of strength and agility?
Strong.
And again, maybe that's a fluke, so why don't you try that other young lady down there? Now, would you do me a favor? Step over here for just a moment. Let's step up here so everybody can see what you're doing. I want you, Angus, to take as long as you want, as long as you need, but I want you to make one of your arms as stiff and as rigid as you just felt their arms. You take whichever one you want, do it any way you want. Let me know when you're doing it.
All right.
Okay. I'm going to use two fingers. Squeak. Try again. All right. You felt yourself. It's different to them, right?
Right.
Okay, ready? Keep trying. All right. Now, you see how this arm is like. Most people think it's easy to make your arm stiff and rigid. It isn't. Don't you notice the difference here? These guys' arms. This is my favorite part. I love that. You know, these guys' arms. Try again, because everybody's watching.
Hold on.
Take as long as you need. Okay. Now, see, this isn't, see how squishy that arm is? This just isn't easy to do, and certainly not the way these folks are doing it. Another thing, if you notice how Angus is doing it, he's trying to make his arm stiff and rigid, and most people who try will separate their feet, grit their teeth, throw their shoulders back a little bit. He's kind of getting his whole body involved in doing one simple task. Thanks, Angus. That's not what these guys are doing. They haven't changed their breathing patterns, they haven't grimaced, they haven't altered their posture at all. The whole focus is in one small area. One other thing I want you to notice about this, they've had those arms hanging there like that for 5 continuous minutes or more. Try to do that when you go home tonight. Try to put your arm out there for any more than 90 seconds and see what it starts to feel like. This is focus in action. Wouldn't it be nice if you get this focused on a goal in business? This is what happens when you focus with imagery. See yourself as an MDRT producer, you're going to have to start doing it as opposed to trying to do it or worrying about it or facing the obstacles. In a moment, folks, I'm going to clap my hands. The instant I clap my hands, those arms are going to turn, rubber bands are going to drop down, and you're going to fall twice as deep asleep. Imagine how good that's going to feel. 3, 2, 1, sleep, 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 deep. Take a nice, another nice deep breath. And drop all the way down. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Would you agree that your emotions affect your performance in this business? I mean, clearly, if you have a positive attitude, if you like what you're doing, if you're confident, if you believe in your product or service, you're very likely to sell more product than a person who has fear of failure, fear of rejection, doesn't really believe in what they're doing. Clearly, your emotional state affects your performance. Well, another thing about visualization that I've always found fascinating is that you have much more control over your emotional state than perhaps you'd be led to believe. Most of you, if you decided to use it, could increase certain positive emotions and decrease negative. Now, there are dozens of ways in which I can demonstrate emotional control. What I'm about to do next is humorous, but there is a message, and I'll explain the message when I'm done. But I just want to explain to you or show you, if I can, a little bit of emotional control. Drifting down deeper, folks, deeper, 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 deeper. Excellent. In just a moment, however, you're going to feel me touch your shoulder. The instant I touch your shoulder, start laugh, Oh my goodness, 200 Sleep! Oh yeah, drop down, deeper, deeper, more relaxed. Observe. What you just saw, in fact, is an excellent example of emotional control. I mean, come on, honestly. If I walked up to any and said, only the person whose shoulder I'm touching, only the person whose shoulder I'm touching, funny, very funny, laugh. 10 times funny. 100 times funnier. This is rolling out of hilariously funny. Did you watch? Could you control your This impresses me. Let me show you what impresses me more. Please. The ability to shut it off like a light switch is a much more impressive level of emotional control. Now, to the point. Some folks, as they approach the close, get a little bit nervous. A friend of mine calls it closmophobia. They get a little bit nervous, fidgety, they talk a little bit faster, they become a little hesitant. People pick that up. Wouldn't it be nice as you got closer to the close, you became calm inside, focused, confident, on track? You can do that by mentally rehearsing, seeing yourself totally focused and in control. Some of you work with other team members. Maybe they have little foibles, things that bother you. You can reduce your distractions and stay focused on the goal, which in your case, obviously, is to do more business and make more sales. Point is, you can increase certain emotions, decrease others virtually at will, with just a little bit of practice, another real valuable tool in learning self-hypnosis. Any questions so far? Let's interview our subjects a little bit, see what they have to say about it. In a moment, I'm going to count from 1 to 5, the count of 5, eyes wide open, still responding to the sound of my voice, still deeply relaxed, feeling fine, eyes wide open, count of 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, sit up straight in the chair, eyes wide open, wait. Give these folks a round of applause, if you don't mind, they're outstanding subjects. Some of you people know at least some of these individuals, correct? So let's look at this gentleman. Are you hypnotized, sir? I asked you that a few minutes ago and you were absolutely positively certain that you were not hypnotized. Do you think you are hypnotized right now?
No.
Good. Limp and loose. Stuck. Fuse. Sealed. Tight. Sticking tighter and tighter. Fusing. Sealing. Lock into your head. By the time I reach number one, you'll discover you cannot pull your hand off your head no matter how hard you try, no matter what you do. Until I touch your forehead. That hand is stuck to your head until I touch your forehead. 1, 2, 3, stuck to your head, eyes wide open, count of 5, 1, 3, 4, 5, ah, hand still stuck. Are you hypnotized? Be honest. Be honest, are you hypnotized?
What?
Are you hypnotized?
No.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Good, do me a favor. Would you raise your right hand, head up in the air? Perfect, would you try to raise your left hand? Try as hard as you can. Tell you what, I'm going to give you an advantage. Maybe if you yank it off there like that, maybe that would give you an advantage. See if you get your hand out. I think you'll find the harder you try, the better it'll stick. I want you to really try. Higher, better. Is this gentleman a producer? Is he a producer? What motivates producers? Who thinks money motivates producers? Let's give a show of hands. Who thinks money motivates producers? Well, see, I think money's a horrible motivator of producers. Most sales managers will tell you it frustrates the heck out of them. If money was this big, giant motivator of producers, you would all be top producers, and statistically, that's probably not the case. See, money has motivational qualities, but not nearly as powerful as most people think. Let me demonstrate what I'm talking about. I want you to really try. Maybe I'm just not motivating you. I'll give you 10 bucks if you yank that hand off your head, but I think you'll discover it's still stuck tight. Try to get it off, but if you can get it off, I'll give you 10 bucks. Tell you what, I'll give you 20 bucks if you get your hand off your head. Harder you try, the tighter it sticks. I'll give you $50 if you can get your hand off your head, but it just keeps fusing. See, I'll give you $100 to get that hand off your head. Your hand off your head, it just keeps sticking. I'll tell you what, I'll give you $200. $200, you can get that hand off your head, but the harder you try, the tighter it's going. Try as hard as you can, possibly can. I'll give you $500 if you get your hand off that head. $500 to get your hand off your head. I'm offering this gentleman $500 to pull his hand off his head. Let's analyze what we got here. Is there anything sticking this guy's hand to his head? Did I put super glue on his hand that he was unaware of? Is there any instant paralysis involved here? No. Here's what's going on. He's holding on very clearly to a picture. He sees his hand stuck to his head like glue. That's the image he's got in his mind. Now, outside of his mind, I'm offering all these supposedly motivating things. I'll give you $500 in cash. He has a picture that's telling him one thing, and the rest of the world's telling him the other. Which part do you see winning out? If you have a battle between your conscious and your unconscious mind, which part's going to win that battle? The overeater looks at the second piece of cake, says, I'm not going to eat it. Subconsciously, they're telling themselves, you always eat two pieces of cake. Who wins? Consciously, they say, I'm not going to smoke anymore. Subconsciously, they see themselves smoking. Who wins that? And it's so easy, just to take it all away. Are you hypnotized?
No.
No, good, good. Glad to hear it. Give this guy a round of applause. Would you like a cake?
You got to look like you do, man.
If you need one, you tell me.
I'm fine.
Is it terribly warm up here for you? Is it terribly warm up here for you?
It's a little hot.
A little hot? Let me ask you a question. Are you hypnotized?
No.
You're absolutely positive with that, too, aren't you? No money involved, because you know, but I'll make you a friendly bet. I'll bet you are.
What?
Hypnotized.
I'll bet you.
Good. Now, you've experienced this before. Was it with a therapist or on stage, or how'd you do it?
Comedy.
My specialty. Deeper and deeper. Oh, deep and deeper. One more, two more, one more. Are you comfortable? Feel okay?
That's not
the one I couldn't get, right? And she's. Great subject. They're all great subjects. Give them a round of applause if you don't mind. Give here the old adage in business, never let them see you sweat. Going to give new meaning to that. I want you all to use your imaginations now. I want you to imagine as I count backwards from five down to one, we are being transported out of this room out to a nice sunny beach on a beautiful sunny day. By the time I reach number one, I want you to imagine you're sitting on a chair out at the beach. Keep your eyes closed, you know, because that sun's very bright. You don't want to hurt your eyes. But by the time I reach number one, we're going to go out to a beach and sit on a nice sunny beach by the time I reach the number one. Three, we're going out to that beach. Two, you can sit up, sit back, put your head back. Three, two, and one. We're sitting out at the beach now on a nice, beautiful day. Put your head back and enjoy it. It's a beautiful, wonderful, sunny day out here. Put your face back. Let your warm, warm feelings of the sun on your face, on your arms, and your legs. And you know what? It's really hot out here. It's a hot day. Hot, hot, and humid. Eyes closed. Hot and sticky. Sticky and hot. And the temperature's rising higher and higher. It's getting uncomfortably warm out here. So warm that you want to cool off. So I'll tell you what. Fan your face. See if that cools you off a little bit. Fan your face. But it's getting warmer. Fan your face. Fan your face. Fan your face. Faster, faster, faster. Fan really fast. Boy, is it hot out here. And you look over the thermometer and you see that it's 95 degrees out here. 95 hot, humid degrees. Sticky, hot, hot, and humid, hot, and humid. Hey, don't worry, I got something to cool you down here. Here's some lotion. Rub this lotion all over your body. It'll cool you down. Rub this lotion. Rub this lotion all over your body. Rub this lotion all over your body. Rub that lotion all in, nice and soothing and cool. But you know, there must have been something in that lotion. I don't know if it was sugar or honey or aloe or something, but it's starting to attract the bugs. Oh my goodness, those swarms of gnats are swarming all around you. Get ready for the bugs. Whoa, here they come. Here they come. All of you did it. You did it. You got all the bugs away. You got all the bugs away. Congratulations, you got every single bug away from you. You did a good job, man.
Sleep.
Oh, yeah, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. I would ask you to observe these individuals' complexions. Look at what they've done in just a short period of time. By visualizing being out in the hot sun, were you able to actually measure their skin temperature, you would see that these people's skin temperature, their extremities, have now increased in temperature on the average 3 to 5 degrees. And most physicians will tell you that you have no conscious control over your visceral or your external temperature, and yet these people just did exactly that. Deeper, more and more relaxed. Loose and any questions about anything you folks are seeing? So what we've shown so far is that through some practiced visualization, you can alter certain things. If you see your arm stiff and rigid like a bar of steel, it will act like a bar of steel. Conversely, if you see yourself writing 100 lives next year, you'll go out there and act like an agent or a producer that should be writing 100 lives. The idea, all that I'm trying to show you here, is that to a great degree, any kind of spaced repetition is going to bring about change in behavior over a reasonable period of time. You can do spaced repetition verbally, you can do spaced repetition with imagery, but by doing it repeatedly, 5 minutes a day for the next 2 to 3 weeks, you ultimately see some very dramatic changes in people's behavior. Any questions about any aspect about what you've seen here this afternoon? Any questions at all about anything? Okay, I should be, yep, just about getting ready to wrap it up. Are there no other questions? Any questions for any of these folks? Pardon? No? You guys just going to buy this hook, line, and sinker without any questions? Yeah. Are there any questions at all here about any aspect of this?
Can we find some members in that guy's head right there? He owes me like $100.
What's your first name, sir?
Sam.
Only person who showed up I'm touching, at the count of five, your eyes are going to pop open, you're going to feel fantastic, but the very first thing you're going to know is you're going to want to go over there and write a check or you're going to give $100 to Sam. One way, shape, or form, you're going to want to give $100 to Sam instantly when I reach number five. Eyes pop right open, you're going to jump over there, and somehow or another, you're going to give Sam $100 at the count of five. One, two, three, four, five. Wait, wait. Sleep, man. How are you doing?
No way.
David?
No.
Okay.
No.
$100. It's irresistible. You got to give him the $100 at the count of five. You just got to give it to him. Eyes open, count of five, one, three, five. Oh, there it is. 10 times more powerful.
No.
Not going to
happen.
Showing that even the best hypnotists can't make somebody do something they're really socially not committed to do. Do you owe this guy the money or not?
No.
Why is he saying that you do?
Because he's a liar.
I really just got me in.
Hold on. I don't want to get in the middle of that. Hold on. Deeper, more relaxed. Loosen limb. I thought he really owed you the money, and I don't know what the deal was, but let's move on. Any other questions? Sure.
How long would they stay out if you just left them alone?
Individual differences. Some people, I walk out the door, 30 seconds later, they come out of it. Some people would stay out. here's the worst thing that absolutely no. Some people say, well, you know, if you walk out the door and you leave hypnotized, they stay hypnotized forever. No, nothing like in the movies. Here's the most dramatic thing that would happen. They would fall asleep, naturally asleep, and then wake up sometime in the future.
Does that work with your wife?
Not a chance. Yes, sir.
Wouldn't this just be easier for us to get you to go on our appointments with us and hypnotize the customer?
You know, I ain't cheap, but I can be had. Are there any other questions?
How do you do it? I mean, how do you continuously, like, what's the visualization you need to put in your head for whatever your goal is?
I'm not sure I understand the question.
I mean, if it's 100 lives, are you just continuously saying to yourself 100 lives and visualizing 100 people? I mean,
that depends on the person. For some people, 100 lives represents a certain income level, getting a new house. For some people, it's a markup on a board. For some people, it's getting up there on the stage with the award in their hand. I've had different people say different things about what they focus on. I spoke to one of your competitors not too long ago, and they were given at the Agent of the Year Award. It happened to be a woman, and I was asking some production questions, and someone said, oh, if anybody's going to know, she will. She's Agent of the Year. And I was talking to her a little bit, and she said, you know, last year, somebody in my office who's a friend of mine got the award. And while he was up there giving his acceptance speech, is when the minute I made up my mind that I was going to be there next year. And every night before I went to bed, I would rehearse my speech. I know what dress I was going to wear, how my hair was going to look, what makeup I was going to have on. She said, I've got it all laid out on the bed. She said, I've been doing that every day for a year. Now that is self-hypnosis. And for that particular person, it was the dress, the hair, standing up there giving the acceptance speech the way she had seen her friend do it the year before. Depends on the person. So I'd experiment. You know yourself better than anybody. What drives you? For some, they truly are driven by money. Not many, but they are. For some, it's the recognition. For some, it's a new house. For some, it's protecting their family or putting money in college for their kids. Depends on the person. Yes, ma'am. Oh, I thought you were raising your hand. I'm going to wrap this up because I don't want to go beyond my time. Very deep, very relaxed, very deep, very relaxed. Concentrating beautifully. Now, in a moment, I'm going to count from 1 to 5. Wait, before I do that, I'm going to count backwards from 3 to 1. As I count backwards from 3 to 1, I'm going to erase all the suggestions that we've had up here. It's not hot or cold anymore. Everything's back to normal. Your hand certainly is not stuck. But still keep going deeper and deeper to sleep. But by the time I reach number 1, all the suggestions are removed and still very deep asleep. 3, going deeper and deeper. 2, all the suggestions totally completely removed. 3, 2, and 1. Everything